is a hard part, I guess.
How do you keep your hair from getting in it?
I usually have it in a ponytail. I didn't realize until a minute ago it was going to start going down in there. So really, at this point, you just kind of have to boss the clay around and make it get into the center. And it takes just kind of arm strength and locking your arms into your hip. And you can see when it's centered that it looks like it's not really moving. Mm-hmm. If you were to put your hands on here, it would just feel very still. This kind of determines what form you're going to make. If you're going to make a bowl, you would want to make this clay low and wide. And for something taller, you kind of come up to a cone like this. Part called pulling. This is when you try to use about 3 or 4 pulls to get it to the height that you want it. And you do this before you shape it. Because the clay wants to go out like that with gravity. I'll always try to like clean it up a little bit from here. Once you get it to the right height that you want, you're going to just check it for, don't want it to be too thin or too thick or have too much bottom weight down here. That's really it. Then you can shape it. You have to go in here and compress the bottom. Get all the bottom out of the bottom. That's really, for what I'm making on the wheel, I'm making some face cups. So I throw these things on the wheel and then I take them off. And after they dry for maybe 2 or 3 hours, then I go back in and start carving and painting on them. So they look a little bit boring. And then I'm just going to dry most of the wire off. Make sure the top is smooth. Then it's time to take it off the wheel. So some people use